our last session, we have a very special guest here with us today, Professor Dr. Rolf Hichert, or the man who invented business communication standards. Hello, Rolf.
Hi, Nasty. Thank you for the inventing. It's not really an invention. It's really my suffering of the last 20, 30 years of not having any kind of standard.
Yeah.
Well, think of maps. I mean, north is up and the rivers are blue. I mean, they all have rules in all these disciplines, but we don't. I mean, if I ask you how does sales look like, you say, well, today it's Thursday. it's a green pie chart. So this is what kills me and what drives me for many years now. I think we need something like the musician have and like the engineers have also in BI. That's what I'd like to discuss with you today.
So you started this journey more than 20 years ago. What would you say has changed in the meantime after all of these
Nothing.
Years?
Nothing. It's so strange. You still have pie charts and radar charts and all kinds of visualization. And people are proud to have different visualizations, just like, I mean, now Mozart, Tchaikovsky, and Beethoven, they were using the same music notes and they were happy to have the same, and it's practical for them. But here in BI, people try to invent new visualizations. It is really incredible what's going on. And I think the major goal we have is to understand your story, to understand the content. And this is what we have to strive for. And
yes.
I'd like to show you some examples.
Please do.
I've prepared a little introduction in high density. I've been to a training of Edward Tufte almost 20 years ago, and Tufte influenced me quite a lot about this issue of high data density. And look at this guy giving this presentation. Our strategy is clear, going from 22 to 25. It is two values only on the big screen. And look at this little piece of music for children. It is seven values on a screen. And here, well, it is 47 already. This guy learns to play the flute and it's 47 notes. But look at the professional. This is professional music notation. It is 51 values, and here we have 50 values. But the Hungarian Rhapsody is not shown bar by bar like here. We might add some more to get the overview, and the musician will use it probably this way to get the overview of the whole music piece. It's 749 notes on here, and then you can, let's say, highlight details if you want to discuss it. Look at the engineers. I mean, this is a shaft, and it's two parts here. But I mean, this drawing has 54 parts, and you can easily depict details and highlight details because there is information density.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this. Can you see can you see it, Nancy? I mean, is
yes.
it clear to see it? I mean, this almost 200 parts, and I can spend 5 minutes explaining all the details of these parts. This is data density at its best.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the map. This is in Switzerland, in the heart of Switzerland. I want to explain you how do you get from Zurich to the next skiing resort to Andermatt. And then you can explain it and tell a story because there is data density. Look at the details of this map.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost 5,000, more than 5,000 data points here. And you can easily depict that there is the ferry boat going across the lake here. This is information density. And this is storytelling. You know, when you hear today the people talking about storytelling, they have weird ideas. It's only one thing. You need to show something, and then you can tell a story. I can talk about this for half an hour.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This is what we get today. Sorry, this is it. This is real world. It's not funny. It's almost funny. It's almost funny. But I mean, what can you tell with these slides? Nothing. Right? Okay. I would like to make a brief overview of how we can condense data. It's depending on the font size. This is 28 points and we have 9 values. Okay. Then we reduce the font size to 14 point and we have more space, 48 values, mm-hmm. 72 values. We go down to, let's say, 12 point. We can go down to 10 point. Do you still see it?
Yes.
Can you still see it? 10 point? Yes, you can. 8, 270 values on one page.
Wow.
Now the goal is to go up to 1,000. We had before with a music, piece of music. So then we need 6 points. This is now about the same size of symbols here from the list piece before. And then we can 200, 500, 1,000 data points. I'm not going in the details of the chart. It's only dummy data. It's copying. But here now you can tell a story. You explain details, talk about correlations and relations, and this is what I think we have to strive for. Information density and not this stuff. Sorry. Do you understand what I mean?
Perfectly well. So if we are talking about information density, then how do we put more information to one report page? I was hoping that you would show us some best practice examples.
Well, I think we should look at the typical problems we have. And the typical problems are things like pie charts and speedometers. I mean, people have complaining about pie charts for almost 100 years. And I would like to show you that pie charts are absolutely forbidden. There are some special occasions, but in the reality, we don't need them for information transfer. So let's look at what we find if we look at pie charts. This is not really helpful. And I would like to explain why this is not helpful. These kind of visualizations. These are real world. It's not trying to be funny. It's real world information. It's either this way or using rings. And I would like to explain how we can improve it using the same space, but we show Spain, the development of Spain, of France, of Greece, using the IBCS way. Don't you use colors if they don't mean anything. Well, if you compare it now, this is 100% of the space and we're using 50%, but you can even understand it on the right hand side and you cannot on the left. I cannot see the development. Mm-hmm. You can see developments which you cannot see on the left. And then we increase information density, use the same space, show the development over time. So even stacked developments here, like here, showed trends or whatever. And this is what I think uses this area, let's say, effectively. And look at this.
Wow.
No, we don't need this. We don't. There's maybe one or two cases where we need it. That's, for instance, in maps. Okay, you know, it's forbidden to color these areas because it shows wrong effects. But we can use, let's say, pies or circles to show different market sizes. And we might show shares of our market in our market size in this pie. That's okay. That's, I think I can agree, we don't need the colors, but this is absolutely useless. Sorry.
So the only use case where you would allow pie charts is when using maps.
Well, there are maybe two or three other occasions detailed, but the typical ones we see, mm-hmm. We can make better, I think, the better. It's the same with speedometers. I mean, they were very similar and they're as useless as as pie charts. They're better means of transferring information. It's about information density. This is what you see in a in a Google picture search, and I write never again because this is not really helpful. This is what you see, and we're misusing the area. It's not data density, it's just the opposite. This is absolutely useless, sorry to say. And you find it all the way, you find it. People are proud of producing now speedometers. We must do it differently. I would like to explain it why this is forbidden. Because we can use the space in a better way. Just like this. I mean, here, it's not useful to point into the red area. No, it's we have to highlight the variance. And why making it round? I mean, it's much easier if you do it this way. And then we have a regular, typical bar chart. We show Paris, Berlin, Bern, Vienna. You make it the IBCS way, a little bit simple and no decoration. And you compare it. I mean, on the right-hand side, within in 2-3 seconds, you see what's going on here. These variances, red and green, are variances. And on the left-hand side, it's difficult. And we compare the area again. It's 100% versus 20%. So 5 times as much and better visual while using these speedometers. No, we don't use them. So if I compare, to make it comparable, use 100% of area, the same size of area, then we can add information, the forecast, the plan, the past, and showing maybe some developments which are important. Sorry, this we do not need, absolutely not. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah, very well. And I can relate a lot because we still see so many speedometers in reports. And, you know, it's also interesting that when people are trying to make speedometers better, they are looking for better speedometers, not for other alternative visualizations.
Yeah. You're right. Well, let's touch a last, I think, incredibly bad development. That is these, I don't know how you call them, these tiles with large I-stars. Sorry.
There's a popular expression for this, big annoying numbers.
Well, I mean, It's not the number size that's important, like this here. And people suggest, look at the difference of the numbers on the right and this 75,000. This is a development. It's really, I think it's very stupid, misusing the area we have on our screen for these things. For me, it's absolutely nonsense, sorry to say. So and even this one, I just do not like. We have to make it better. And when you look at what is suggested here, this is from Microsoft, they suggest, okay, use these important information for the GDP in this case. Card visualizations are a good way to display an important number prominently. I do not think so, not at all. We have this precious space and we use it perfectly, as much data as we can get. Be sure to provide context, it's been said here. So we say the GDP, we show this number, that's this number, but not making the number bigger than the title. How stupid is this? To make the number bigger than the title, we don't know what it is. So then We show the development of the GDP. We show it this way, we show it this way, whatever we want to show. And then we use this space this way, and we can add this high information density in our dashboard. Now, it was not GDP here, it was gross profit margin. There's a different notation because it's a percentage notation. And this is okay, I think. And this is not really helpful. Okay.
I couldn't agree more. Displaying just one big number without any context is very much useless.
No, it is really not. And I mean, we just touched only what one issue that bothers me, and I just do not like this data density issue. It's also about scaling, it's about titles, it's about so many things. I think we have to be better in developing our dashboards. It's not about nice looking dashboards. People discuss great dashboards. They look fancy. I mean, Beethoven was not evaluated by the beauty of his music notes. He was evaluated by the music he was with. And the same thing you find all over. They discuss the beauty of these visuals. It's absolutely nonsense. We have to look about the story we want to tell. And we want to be honest and clearly telling our story. It needs data density.
So what would you suggest that we do? How do we eradicate all of the cases of these bad visualizations disease?
Well, I think I made some suggestions to use the area better, and it's not new. I mean, people discuss this for many years, but what kills me, it doesn't change. I mean, we still see the system. I mean, there's critiques in all this for many, many years, but they're still existing. It's like a disease. They look nice, but they're not helpful. I don't know. I really, I'm a little bit disappointed that for the last, I'm now maybe more than 30 years in this business, and I've seen many, many applications. And well, there's some good ones. I know we are here on a conference. They are following the IBCS way in a very close way. I like it, what's been done and achieved in the last years. And I think if Zebra helps us to get the idea across, this would be good for IBCS and it would be good for Zebra.
And where do you see business reporting in the next 10 years?
Well, we can kill the pie chart and the speedometers and come back to the stories. And again, I just wrap it up. If you have good information, a good data density, there is always a story behind. You don't need to explain your charts. The charts should explain us the content. It's like in the PowerPoint world. You know, people explain their PowerPoints, but it's not explaining the PowerPoints with 1,000 words. It's the PowerPoint should, yeah, explain it to us. 1,000 words. You can look a long, long, long way in dashboards or PowerPoint presentations until you find 1,000 words. I mean, they don't give. How can a pie chart present 1,000 words? It's not possible. Nasty, I think we have to work in this direction. No, I mean, that means proper scaling, high information density, clear titles, clear stories, and this will be the future, I hope.
Well, I hope so too, and we'll do our best to help people overcome data visualization challenges and, you know, just help everybody make better reports. So thank you a lot, Rolf, for being here with us today. We appreciate it every time you come on stage with us, and I hope to see you here next year again.
Okay, thanks, Nasty. Bye.